Hey guys, Clumsy here, and welcome back to Transport Fever. Now in the previous episode, wow, perfect timing. Super silent trains. No sounds whatsoever except the rolling wheels. Probably because it's an electric truck, huh? Anyway, in the previous episode, we built this train, actually. Did I say truck? We built this train. We connected the farm over here at the northern mountainside with the processing plant over here, creating a huge tunnel underneath. Let me show you. There. Through and through. Double tracks and everything. And then we created a route using these beautiful trucks with awesome sounds, connecting them to this station via a beautiful bridge to this cargo container station, which has a built-in truck stop over here. The only thing is, seems to be it's not working because if you look at the potential of demand here for food, it's only 92, and it looks like all the demand is instead going to this processing plant, 6,830. So it looks like they're not sharing potential. They're not distributing it accordingly, even if they are sharing the same station right here. Yeah, so we do have some food being delivered from this processing plant onto the cargo station. There you can see 5. It will arrive here, but that 5 will just be delivered, I think, to these commercial areas here. So if we look at this, the scope, the catchment of this truck station over here, it includes those blue things, those commercial areas, and I think that's where the food is getting delivered to. But everywhere else, like the other parts, even the other parts of this city, and the north and south lines are not being connected. I think it's a limitation of the game, that it cannot really see everything, it cannot share demand across multiple sources of cargo, of freight, like food. So what I was asking you guys in the previous episode before we ended was, do you guys think we should just remove this connection over here? So we let the processing plant to the south focus on demand to the south, and we focus on the north for this processing plant, so they sort of get separate supplies altogether. They won't share anything. Like these trains here, they'll stop on this station, they'll no longer go through this one, eventually to this part. It's a shame, I know, but I think it's the only way to go. And sorry if someone commented already, because I figured out, I realized I had to go out this weekend, had to go back to Manila, spend a long weekend because it's Labor Day, and so I have to record in advance, and so I haven't really seen any of your comments yet, because I've been recording this even before the previous episode has been released, time travel. So yeah, I am going to assume that you guys are okay with it. If not, then let's forget it happened, right? So what we'll be focusing on this episode is creating that one over here, making sure that all our trains in the north line do not go here anymore, that they stop on this one instead. And you might not need actually to destroy any tracks. Maybe it's enough to just remove the first stop here. Hexham Central, that was, I think, right? This one. So if we, for example, let's have that guy get that, and let's see. Okay, if I remove this stop, okay, that removes the line totally here, 87 of 130. I think that kind of wrecks stuff here though, because we don't have a merging lane in here. Yeah, you can see the brown brown line disappear completely. So what I'm thinking is, I think we need to merge, have a merging lane. Wait a minute, how do we do that? And where do we go? I think we can stick to this one. So we can probably create a merge from, where's the end of the station? Here, alright. So we can probably create a merge from here. This will also make it look more realistic. Crossing over this place. Yeah. And the curvature, the speed has to be 160 only. But if you look at that point, that's only 84. So we have to make it as far away as we can. That's 99 over there. Come on, give me 160. You probably won't need it, but it will be most realistic. There you go, 160. 300, good to go. There you go. And the brown line is still not intact. Why? Let's see. Abingdon the north is this one. Oh, okay. We need to remove that one because it's repeating the first and fourth. Doesn't want that. So if we remove that, then the brown line is back. There we go. Okay. So, I think we'll need to put a signal here as well. Okay, so with this in mind, that means the rightmost track here will never have, at least this part, will never have any trains. This platform here where this train is, they won't go there ever anymore because they'll all be stopping on this platform. Yeah, and we'll see how that goes later on. They should be able to correct themselves properly. We'll see how it works. So they will wait on each other. Yeah. Once this train leaves, this train should follow. And then there, we did have another train in here. I think I can just, yeah, it's going. I think we can just retain this, retain the tracks. Let's not delete anything because we might need it. Maybe in the future, the game, the developers will fix it, make it more shareable. And then we can easily go back, just adding a stop at the beginning of the line. Okay, they're moving. They are moving. That means we have three extra lines in here. Or actually, that means if we ever push the fuel line southwards from the north to south, that means you also need only one line because we'll probably stop here as well. Because anything below that, anything here, should be covered by the fuel depot over at, where was it again? Here. Which is producing almost 1.6. Yeah? So yeah, I think that is more than enough. The unfortunate thing here is we'll have to stop. Yeah, the goods production is also getting limited. So if we look at the goods demand here, that will fall down. I think that might have fallen already because we removed the link. Previously, the goods could have been delivered already to this place. And then in turn, goods could have been delivered from here onwards. But since we destroyed that link, that means the northern cities would never get any goods anymore unless we create goods. A goods network here up top, which we probably will not, but that's fine because as it is right now, and sorry if I'm scrolling too fast, just super excited, as it is right now we already have 1300 demand and we can barely keep up with the supply, so it's not as if we're losing a lot here, right? Yeah, so let's keep that. Let's make sure, let's go and check what happened to the demand in this plant. Okay, now we only have 1,300. That should be manageable. Right, that means 4,000 plus or 5,000 plus got routed to this one. 3,500. So if we add that, 3,500 plus, yeah, my math sucks. I used to be good at math back in college, back at school. Got rusty, I guess. 3,500 plus 1,300 is 4,900, around 5,000. It's not 6,000. It might be still adjusting. But the good thing is we are seeing proper demand here now. If you remember, the second processing plant over at Brixham previously only had 100 demand, and now it's getting much, much more. So that means the train here, wherever it is underground, will be definitely pushed to produce more. Yeah, potential 90. That should increase as well. I'm not sure if I should upgrade my train first, but I'm expecting this one to just keep on ramping up, and then eventually we'll need to upgrade our train. Yeah? So unfortunately, there will be a bit of scarcity of food in the northern lines while this processing plant is trying to pick up, but that's fine. In the meantime, while we're waiting for that, let's go and do some adjustments on the passenger line. So, I did mention previously that I wanted to change the circle line. I wanted to upgrade their trains. So maybe we can do that while waiting. Let me just confirm that... Oh, I forgot the signal. You guys will for sure tell me. I forgot the signal here. So the merge is over here. Before the merge, let's put the signal right there. Yeah. So the train will stop right there before they collide with each other. I think that's actually a bit too forward. It must be over here. There we go. Nice. Right, so that means they probably won't be carrying much in the meantime. And why is this train waiting? Oh, there is one here. Do we have too many trains now on the network, on the line? Or are they maybe spacing themselves out still? Let's wait for that. Okay, let's wait for that. Right, so I did want to upgrade my train line from dual stops trains. These are getting pretty old, look at that. Yeah, they're getting pretty dirty. From dual stocks trains, they are earning 15 and 14 million, almost even earnings. I wanted to replace them with something that was requested, which I think will look pretty cool as well. This one, the Stadler Geruno EC250. And the question is, which one would be picked? It's actually the same thing, mostly the same thing. Realistically though, this will be in Zurich, this one would be in Frankfurt. I'm not sure. Is that the place? Personenwerkers, or is it Personenwerkers von Zurich? And the other one is Strecke von Frankfurt. That's probably the destination in real life, but for us, AL and LA, not sure what that means. For me, it's the same. I'll just pick the first one. Or actually, we might be able to pick one for each line, one for the clockwise and one for the counterclockwise. So let's pick that. That is 202 meters though. Crap. Wait a minute, let me do a check. That will exceed this one, so we'll have to adjust this. Oh, I hate it. That will exceed this one, so we'll have to adjust it. Yes. And that will exceed this one as well. Don't tell me. Oh man! Okay, so we'll have to change all the stops to make that work. I don't think we'll have enough time for that. Let me see. Okay, this one isn't updating. That's bad. That is bad. This one isn't stepping up at all. Let me look at the train here. Is the train not carrying anything at all? Just 27, so it can handle more. Where is it? It's there, underground. That's the problem with tunnels. You can't appreciate their beauty. So I would have preferred to make a bridge, but it does work best underground. Sneaky. All right. Yeah, so we'll be operating at a loss until that gets fixed. I'm not really sure how that would work. Let's give it a bit more time. We'll try to adjust the stations here. This is what I'm scared of though. If I extend this, we might impact this line. And I'm not sure if the TGV will be able to work with that. It is a straight line though for the TGV, so ideally the other trains will slow down, but this one won't. And in reality, we don't even need these parts here, because this is the end of the line already for these lines. So we only have to adjust two. Let's try that. Let's try. Pause it. And before I proceed, you guys gave me a tip how to do this when creating, when working with tracks, creating platforms, upgrading them, and something. It is best to set these signals to one way, because you know the problem when you destroy a track and then your trains move the other direction and they get stuck for months and months if you don't notice manually. I think that gets solved if you just set that to one way, so they don't have a choice, they can't go back. And I think it should be enough to set just one signal one way, or maybe one for each direction to be safe. Maybe we can set this one just to be super safe. We don't need all the signals, just because if it's one way in one segment, it's one way the entire segment, right? If there's no junction in there. Okay. I wish, you know, when you're building the signals, maybe I hope there was a way to make a one-way signal, like a third icon here, which is a one-way. That would have been much easier, so you don't have to check each box manually. Anyway. Let's go and fix this up. Delete that. I don't think we need that at all. Okay, so I got that notice. Hopefully this still works. Upgrade you to 240. Okay, that's a bit wide, but I think that's fine. Let's number one priority, TGV. Yep, 300, perfect. Okay, we did this quite well. We made this compatible for upgrades. Now this one will slow down for sure, but it's fine. 79 going out, going in, that should be okay. And let me just connect this because it looks really good. It looks really pro when you see merging tracks like that. And I missed this one. One sec, misclick. There you go. Was that 300? I didn't really see anymore. Yep, it is. Okay. And then let's also connect this over there. 54, slowest speed ever. It's fine. It's all for show. You can even make crossings, like something like that, make it more realistic looking. That's too sharp though, won't fit here. Okay, let's leave it like that. And then let's connect this. Hopefully this is 300 as well. This is the TGV track. Yep, 300, and you 300, perfect. Okay, we're good. And you guys 151, that should be fine. Yeah, let me connect you as well for future use, maybe. All right, that's one down. Now let's go and check what happened to our trains. The TGV train first and foremost. Nothing here, interestingly enough. All our TGV trains are up north. Why aren't you spaced out correctly? Are you stuck or something? There we go, TGV train. Yeah. Let's see. Okay, that's the one. Okay, still the right direction. Perfect. So it might be that those signals actually worked. It might be. We'll need more tests for sure, but in the meantime, I think they do work. Is this a TGV line? It's a counterclockwise line. Okay. And you are Brixham Food. You are an MAN all cargo. Let me just do this very quickly. MAN all cargo. Can we change you? Hey, I like something better. Maybe the red one. Is this for everything? Yeah, I think. Yeah, let's replace them with one of these more colorful styles. TCH. I'm not familiar with the brand. That's probably a very common truck in Europe. Replace? Not yet. Which one is the old one? I think it's just approaching. And let me just compare the stats here. So this one is 100 kilometers, 20 versus the man all cargo. This is faster. But the speeds are only up to 100 anyway. That doesn't really matter. The capacity is the same. The power, this truck has much more power. This 40 ton truck, this red one, than this. It's also less expensive, interestingly enough. Probably because of the top speed. Yeah, okay. Let's leave that. Alright, so let's go and check. TGV trains are working properly. What else? Which train else? The circle line seems to be working properly as well. Yeah? Where are our other trains? This one, it's working fine. Yeah, seems like it's worked. Perfect. Right, just looking at my trains quickly. Yep, good. All right, before we proceed, let's go and check. Still 100. That's not good. That's not improving. Okay, it looks like we'll have to step up on the train, either the frequency or the size of it. Look at that, it's maximum already 120. Let's get a bigger one. Let's say this one, let's replace you with a bigger truck, a bigger train rather. Let's stick with these ones. These are pretty cool. How do we do that again? I think it's, which one's the front? If I look at this vehicle. Okay, so that one goes first, and then we pick some locos. We can random it up with all these goods wagons that we got in the previous episode. That looks really cool. All of them should have the same stats. Yeah, so let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and get one more at the end, like so. 12.2 million, 143 meters. Actually, we can afford more wagons. 165, I think that should be good. Our platform can for sure handle that. Pause the game. Make sure we finish before that train arrives. And actually, let me see. 174 meters. Okay. Let's try that. Just replace one time. 4.43 million only. Okay, so let's have it replaced. Drops of food. Gets longer. And now it should be able to handle 120. And crap, we didn't. We didn't. Wait. Wait, send vehicles to depot. Actually, because I want to copy it as well. Theoretically, so before you only had access to change what goods they were hauling when they were in a depot. But now, because you can replace them on the fly, I think you should be able to do that as well here. Like, yeah, there, and then just say replace now. That might cost something, probably not, because they get sold at 100% value anyway if they're new. But what I wanted here was to get one more train. Just copy that. Actually, no, I didn't want to copy it. 13.3, and just to prove the point, 13.3, 13.3, because it's new. Oh man, I should have. Maybe that it's as easier to do it that way. So let's do it like this. So if I buy a wagon and I do this one by one, like that. No, go up. And only livestock. Only livestock. So everything we purchase should be livestock only, won't it be? No, it gets reset. Crap. All right. So then let's buy everything in one go first. Like, can we not set that here? No, I don't think so. 1, 2, 3 livestock. 1, 2, 3 One for each. It's gonna be much longer, but fine. And this one, livestock. 1, 2, 3 And then let's put that back up. Now it's 252 meters. Everything livestock. Let's copy that. I'm not sure if that will have enough of torque. Having two engines like this, it might be, it might not be enough. Compare that with this one, 300. Okay, it's like, yeah, it is almost as powerful, two of these, almost as powerful as one of those class 185s. So it should work, I think. Okay, let's see how that works. So ideally, that should push the production on this one, since the frequency will be better. And what else? The frequency will be better, and they will have more capacity per trip, ideally. That also looks a lot better, more organized in terms of the wagons getting grouped together as one. Yeah, that looks really cool. I like that. 180 capacity each train. Alright, let's leave that as it is currently. We'll see how it goes. Okay, next one. This one, I assume, should be enough. Thank you, 320. What is this? Oh, perfect. Look at that. It's perfect. So the trains are actually running out already. They are expiring in terms of lifetime. So it's just perfect that we start replacing them. Let me pick that again for feels. Clockwise, go with the LA. Set you to yes. And counterclockwise, pick the other one. Just so we can see if there are any minor differences. Yeah, auto replacement. Let's leave it as it is. Actually, let's go and replace now. There you go. There you go. All lined up over there. Now that will mean at some points they will exceed the platform and it won't look good for sure. But you'll have to bear with that for a bit, guys. All right. We'll fix things as they go, like this one. Okay. Let's go and have a look. Full train. I forgot to see the stats. Look at that. Hey. Wait a minute, isn't this just right? 160 meters, this is 202 meters, so it exceeds by around 40 meters, but, oh yeah, the head is missing. Yep, yep, definitely exceeding the platform, but look at that, look at how beautiful that train is. Oh man, yeah, unfortunately you can't take a screenshot like that. With the loco missing. Yeah, but we'll see. This one has 131 capacity. Loading speed, I assume, is much better. and dual stock 12 times versus dual stocks has where's the dual stocks? Open your eyes. Pretty nice horn. It's actually slower. My mistake. It can carry more though, and it is much more powerful. No, not in terms of tractive effort. So it might end up to be a bit slower actually. We'll see. But they look cool, so let's leave it be. Stop. Stop, stop, stop. Where are the first set of signals here? Right. So let's go and set these to one way. Yeah. Hopefully it didn't destroy anything. Let's leave the line manager on so we can see if the lines disappear suddenly. Not expecting any problems, but you know how it goes. All right, there we go. And when we destroy this, I won't check it anymore, but I'm expecting that that will get fixed, but that will not destroy our direction of the trains. So pick one, 240. Oh man, you will have to go for science. Okay, 240, yep. So that one should reconstruct itself anyway, I think. Yep. And then let's just connect these again. 300, 300. This is pretty straightforward, just a straight line. This one is a bit bendy. Actually, yeah, it is a bit bendy. Might be able to give a bit more room here, like that. Yep, there you go. 245 and 300. One building will be removed. Sorry about that. Nothing I can do. Good. One more down. One more to go, I think. Okay, this one. This one would hurt. Yeah, I can expect we'll have to destroy a couple of things here. Man. So we will have to destroy that merge there. We'll have to be sure to bring that back in. But before we do, let's set these to one way. Make sure we're not affecting anything. We'll be destroying this anyway, but let's set that to one way anyway, just to be safe. And these ones one way. Yeah, you know, if I had the choice, I'll make all the signals one way. But it will be too much work doing this one by one. Okay. So now, if we look at the upgrade, 240 meters, we'll be hitting a lot of things. We'll be hitting the road there. We'll have to destroy that. The tracks, that's no problem. We'll be deleting that. And the bus station we'll have to replace. But that shouldn't be a problem, I think. We will see. Okay. Okay, that should be enough. Next one. We destroy that. 500k. We destroy that. And we upgrade this. 240 meters, now that's possible. High speed, yes, okay. Four tracks should be good. Perfect. And then, let's pick a different truck station here. A bus station. Can we not have a small one? That's not allowed. Okay, this is the super expensive one, I think. Yeah, look at that. 20 million just for that thing. Why would you pay 20 million for that? It's insane. Okay, what is this? Tram and bus station. It's the same one we have. Actually, we'll have to destroy that building. But we can bring it back mostly. This one has four stations. We don't really need that. Actually, we only need the smallest one. So I can actually live with that, this, although the direction is opposite. So alright, let's go with this one then, the same one. Looks like a skateboard park from above, actually. I'm not sure. seems that way to me at least. Right, there you go. So now the lines should be back. Okay, yep, it is. And these ones we just connect like so. Just drag it over. 190, 158 in the beginning. I'm not complaining about that. I will need to slow down anyway. Okay. And these ones, just connect it like so. 300, straightforward. No problemo. These ones, 300 as well. And what we just need to do is create that merge one more time. Try to make it as... Wait a minute. Let me do this the right way. So, outgoing, from the platform outgoing, you don't need to be fast because they're starting from zero. But if they're coming from here, getting into the platform, to the station, they need to be as fast as they can. So we prioritize this track. That means the merge should be here. The diagonal stuff should be the one from the platform. If that makes sense. That's one of your tips as well for me. And that makes a lot of sense. So that means this diagonal thing doesn't need to be as fast because the trains that will be using this will be coming from this platform, which will be starting from zero speed. So there's no real need to make it 300, but if we can, why not? Let's make it as fast as possible then. Just in case. Maybe 200. I think these are dual stocks trains with 200 max speed. Okay, that's the limit. And that is 201. Okay, let's do it. Let's go with that. Perfect. Lines should be back. Yes, they are. And then the only thing we're missing is that signal over here. Like so. Make it one way as well. Okay, good. Now everything should be 240. Should fit that new EC250 train. Dual stocks working. Let's go have a quick look. This line, you are a clockwise line, so you should be headed to the left, to the west. Yep, that's the new train. Wait a minute. Can we even this out a bit? This might make for a good photo op. High brush strength, large brush. Prettify it. Okay, that looks a lot better. Well, that can work. That looks beautiful as heck. This actually reminds me of the NEX train in Japan. The one we rode from Narita Airport to Tokyo. It has the similar color, like white majority with a bit of red trim and black. It looks like a Gundam leg. If you're familiar with Gundam. Only the NEX train has a bigger head, like a mushroom head, so to speak. That's how I would put it, at least. Now, I'm not sure what the difference of this train is compared with the other one. And they have a restaurant car. Ah, I love going through those when we were in Europe. It's the perfect experience. Trying that for the first time, being in a train, a full-on proper train, and getting into the restaurant and just having breakfast, having coffee while the train was moving. It was a concept pretty alien to me. Probably for you guys, it was nothing special, but for me, I don't even get on trains, let alone eat on them. This does seem a bit slow. Well, it is kind of steep, I give it that, but it seems to be having trouble here in this climb. Maybe it needs rubber tires or something, I don't know. But the good thing is, it seems like the trains are indeed moving properly. I don't think they are stuck anywhere. So that's perfect. Although this one seems to be lost in translation. I think he still got problems. Yeah, went the wrong way. and I'm not sure why. Maybe I needed to also put these into one way because it depends where the train is. Maybe instead of adjusting where you're editing the tracks, maybe you should look at the train and adjust the signals in between them, or where they are in between of, if you get what I mean. But I think as a general rule, it's just best practice to make everything one way, just to be error-proof, foolproof. Yeah, that's my advice at least. If you can afford the effort, it will save for many headaches in the future. Okay, everything good. We're getting passengers again, more or less. We're losing money though, look at that, 17.4. Probably one of the train on that point in, what is that? Riffield. You upgraded, yep. It became an EC250. Which is, what do you call this again? A Stadler or something. Won't this... if you mouse over it, doesn't appear. It's a Stadler Geruno. There you go, EC250. I do like it very much. But I still don't get the difference in terms of looks with that versus this one. It's mostly the same to me. If you guys are familiar with it, do let me know, alright? Oh, this one side by side, actually. Oh! Okay, what's the difference? Well, from this one, SBB CFF FFS. SBB CFFS, same one. They should be technically the different train, at least in terms of choice. But I don't think they are. What's weird as well, why am I always seeing number one there? Isn't this the car number? And then this one, I see two everywhere. I must be reading this wrong. I know there should be somewhere here which says what car it is, right? Because in your ticket, you would have a car number. But that's probably for handicapped people, that blue sign. I saw a wheelchair below it. Where was it? Wait. Give me a moment. There. Oh, there's actually a guy inside. Cool. There you go. Yeah, so it might be related to handicapped. So maybe that's seat number one. That's not car number, that's seat number. But then again, why are there two seat number ones in the same car? I have no clue. Anyway, let's keep going. We have that all set. We got back our money. In terms of passengers, we are getting a lot of passengers still here. That's good. I kind of forgot about this train. This is a Stadler as well, I think, right? It's pretty sleek. Yeah, it is getting a bit laggy though, sorry about that. But I think in terms of how it looks, it is well worth it. Yep, look at all the passengers in here. Beautiful. I'm quite pessimistic though if we'll earn more money. As you can see, all the income we had before, like 15, 14 million, they're gone. But they should be back. They should be back soon. Look at this, negative 46 million for the train food north. Because we have 6 trains there and they're delivering absolutely nothing. So yeah, we'll have to fix that pretty soon. Okay, I am getting more potential here. But I don't think these wagons, these trains, are carrying anything more. Like this one hasn't increased still. What the heck? Even went down. Okay, I'm stumped here, guys. I put the train, there is demand, but the potential for livestock hasn't increased. Look at that demand. 3,082. Has enough livestock in there and it's not producing much. It won't even reach 100. Do I have to recreate this? because I can. We do have a tool here, an industry tool, where we can. This is available in debug mode. And debug mode can be turned on in the options in the main menu. But once you have turned that on, you can have a new button here, where you can actually create a new food processing plant like so. Yeah, it will cost money, but if it will fix our problem, I'm more than happy to reset it. Maybe delete this and create a new one. Maybe that should refresh stuff. What do you guys think? We still have time. We can probably try it. Let me just save the game first. And then we'll try it. At least we have something to go back to if all hell breaks loose. Okay. Here we go. Can we delete you? Well, that's one problem. We can't delete it. Maybe in debug mode we can. Let me see. Construction materials plant. There should be a part here where we can delete something, right? Or maybe not. Okay, don't think that works then. Okay, that doesn't work. So it looks like you cannot delete industries. You can place them, but you can't delete them once you put them down. I think I saw that somewhere in a mod. Alright, deliver more livestock, it says. Absolutely insane. Okay, so if I... how do I do this? Unpause the game. The potential for livestock is increasing. Maybe we just haven't given it enough time, because I did upgrade the trains, but I did pause the game as well when I was creating those new lines. So maybe we need more time. Yeah, let's give it the benefit of the doubt. So let's leave it there for now. But if you have any ideas, guys, do let me know, okay? Look at that. Potential is 58 only. That's actually pretty disappointing. The frequency is 145 seconds. It's actually pretty good. Does it need one more train? I doubt it. Usually, even if you don't have the trains, it would just keep on pumping livestock in here until it actually fills the platform up. This time, though, it doesn't. I don't get it at all. Ah, oh, it's so frustrating. Yeah, even the production went down. Look at that. Maybe there are not enough cows and chickens in the mountains. Maybe the goats are not plentiful. Maybe we need to ship grain as well. No, it shouldn't be. It shouldn't be. Because the processing plant here, if we look at it. Actually, we haven't reviewed this one. Yeah, look at that. So much. Oh, wow. Why do we have 921 left? I think somewhere in on the road, the limit was reached. Somewhere along the supply chain, the connection was cut. Because this was previously 1,300, I remember. So full production ahead, full trains I'm assuming? Not really. This train could have carried 100 more, interestingly enough. Interesting. Okay, this is full. Full train. How is Hexam doing? Hexam is doing pretty good. Alright, so... maintain status quo there. This one has full livestock. And this one has so much food in it. Look at that. Wait a minute. Don't tell me. Is there a train stuck somewhere? Don't tell me. It is the yellow line. Okay, this one. Why does it have only 13 wagons? Okay, it's moving. It is moving. But I think we need one more. Yeah. Looks like we need one more because that is 143. It can carry a maximum of 169. But then the food waiting here is 337. So yeah, let's build one more. We'll have to step it up here. Vehicles, that one. Let's just copy it. What color the? That olive color. Okay. This one, olive color is that that one? Yep. So get a class 185 and then 13 goods wagons. We can actually pick the new wagons in here as well. But it will slow down the train and it will not be symmetrical with the existing one we have. So let's just copy this. I didn't count. Let me turn on the line manager. There we go. You can see 7 until 13. Perfect. And go. Okay, now there are 2 trains in there. I think we can actually afford to make that more. No, it should be enough. It should be enough. If we look at the number of food there. 221. By the next trip, they will be able to get everything already. So that should be fine. And here, I don't think we need anything more as well currently. But here, yes, I think you guys told me about this as well. We need a new line here. So currently, we only have one line going to South Emsal, which is carrying construction materials and food and goods. But then, well, it looks like we'll need to separate it. We'll need to create one more line. This time, creating a separate line for conmats and one for goods and food. Because they are different types of wagons, different types of cars. Alright, I'm good with that. So this one is full. The other train should be full as well. Okay. Picking that up. Okay, yeah, that looks good. That looks promising. So much food in here. But that is going to get picked up with the next train. It's no problem. Hastings. This is just a monster now. Look at that. Yeah, there we go. Potential is increasing again. So we've gotten rid of the bottleneck at least. And this one though. Okay, that's good. That's good. This is scheduled to upgrade. When it upgrades, it will require more livestock. And when it does, this one will be forced to pump out more. Yeah, it is increasing slowly. Alright. So it looks like it's working. Phew. Okay, let's give it a bit more time. And we'll see in the next episode if we need to do something. In terms of demand, 3,000 here, 3,000 down below. So north 3,000, center 3,000, we're good. We have a good split. My only regret is still, yeah, we can't carry goods anymore. Maybe we can have a separate line from here to here, which will only carry goods. We can do that. Yeah, that's true. We can even utilize this station. Like, this track, we connect to that place instead, to this rightmost track. And then the goods train, which will be coming from this station to this one, will be dropping off goods only. And it will be stopping here in the middle, in the second line. Like, to the right of this brown track, this one. That can work. Yes. So in that way, we can still retain the goods. And will specifically say you carry only goods. That sounds like a good deal. Right, but anyway, I have taken up too much of your time already, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed the episode. It was a bit of a mix freight and cargo. Actually, cargo and passenger episode. So hopefully that made everybody happy. Because some people like passengers only, some people like freight, some people like both, thankfully. But yeah. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more updates. In the meantime, this is the Clumsy Geek signing off. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Bye guys, have a nice day.